Hello friends, welcome to a new design with Farhad YouTube channel video. Today I will show you how to design this cool wall banner. You will learn a lot of new skills. Don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell to get the future updates. Let's get started and don't waste the time. First things first, I'll open a new file and set the specifications. First, I'll give a proper name, then set the dimensions, then I'll set the resolution, and at the end, I'll set the color mode. When done, I'll hit create, a new file opens and is ready for new design. A good and professional practice is to set your guidelines. It will help you work with more precision and align elements easily. Now I'm going to save the file, give it a related meaningful name. It will help to get through faster. It's time to bring the primary colors we will use in this design. I put it in the corner for later referencing. It will help a lot. Here, I use the shape tool and draw a rectangle with green color and put it as the background of the banner. After I set the background, I will bring in the elements of the design from my computer. The first element is a picture of a boy. I import it and then I will remove its background and crop it to the element we need and then drag it to our main design file. First, place it in the center of the design and we'll continue the design. To make other elements stand out, I'll create a lighter green color as the lightning on the green background. To achieve this effect, I'll use the gradient adjustment layer and play with its settings to get the target effect. Then I'll place the effect in between the elements and on the green background. When the lightning effect is ready, I will start creating the sunshine rays to make the lightning even more brighter. To achieve this effect, I will use the selection tool and draw a ray, and then I will use the step and repeat method to repeat the ray in specific distance and as well as the same angle. First, I will make a copy of the ray, place its anchor point in the center of the page, and rotate it to a certain degree. Hit OK. Then I will use the shortcut key Ctrl Shift Alt and hit T as many times as I need. It will repeat my steps in a certain degree and the result will be a beautiful sunshine effect. Now I will work on the rays to get adjusted to other design elements. I will use a layer mask to mask out the unnecessary parts. I will use a soft edge brush and remove the unwanted parts. Then I will play with its opacity to make it even subtler. At the end, I will use a blending option to blend the rays to the background. It will result in a seamless ray in the background. Thank you. It's time to bring the title. I'll paste the title in a text layer. Then I will increase its size, align it in the center, put it behind the boys layer, work on scallop. I'll get closer to our final title design. I will play a little bit with the text settings such as tracking or line spacing, letter spacing, font variation, and so on to get the final touch. At the end, place the title in top center of the design. To get even better look for the title, I'll start spending some more time here. Here I'll work on the layer style, put some shadow, work on its intensity, size, and distance. When done, I will hit OK. Then continue on working with its line spacing and letter spacing until it looks more pleasing to the eye. When the title is done, I will pause and look a little bit more to see if everything fits together perfectly. I have found that I should add some more shine to rays. To get this effect, I am going to work with the gradient adjustment layer and put it on the top of the layer, the ray layer. Play with settings until I am satisfied with the results. It is time to add other elements of our design. I have decided to add some stationary elements like pencil, pen, book, and so on to add school feel and learning feelings. Here I will drop the assets from my computer and then adjust their sizes, position, location, and rotation to meet the overall design look. When finished, I will start working on an effect to harmonize all the looks of elements together better. I will get this done by adding some adjustment layers and blending it to the group of the stationary elements. The result will be a cool look of elements that have the same feeling. To make the boy stand out, I will add some shadows to it. I will hold Ctrl key from keyboard and click on the boy's layer to make a selection around it. Then I will add a new layer and fill the layer with a darker green color. Hit Ctrl D to deselect and move the shadow a little bit to the left and make a copy of it and fill it with a lighter green color and again move it to the left to get this cool effect. Now, I will select both of them, group them and convert them to smart object and rasterize it. Then hit Ctrl plus T to get free transform tool, right click on it and select warp. Now I am able to move different parts of its shadow freely to get a new cool effect of our shadow. To get a fresher look of the shadow, I will add a saturation adjustment layer and play with the necessary settings to get a fresher look and closer color to the shadow. Okay, let's get back to our text content. I am duplicating the text title text layer, and I will copy each text and place it in its own text layer from this layer. Then I will start working on it as the same as I have worked in the main title, except that settings such as color, font size, font variation, tracking, letter spacing, case look will be specific to the text and its position on our design. Each of the texts that we are going to place on this design will be worked the same as this one, but with their own specifications. Now that the text is adjusted, we need icons that represent each of the bulleted text and have a related meaning to each of the list item. So I'll go to my computer and drag the icons from my assets folder that I have already collected and put it in the specific location. Then I will adjust the icon in the circle around it accordingly. Change its color, align it to the list item content, and work with font size and spacing until it looks pleasing, and adjust it accordingly. You should work up until it looks seamless with all other elements on the design. Okay, we are almost finished. Here I am going to do some final adjustments to the elements of our design. I am going to work on position, rotation, scaling and color of the texts, titles, graphic elements and the shadows. To take the focus of the viewers to our design and keep him focused, I am going to add a little bit of a wavy and curvy background shadow to the boy in the center of this design. It helps to put some weight in the center of our design. To make it look seamless with other elements, I will add some effects using gradient adjustment layer and clip it to this element. I will play with its color settings and positioning until it looks pleasing to the eye and conform to all other elements. The final element that needs to be on our design is the logo. I have prepared the logo and saved it in the assets folder. I am dragging it to the canvas and work on its position, and as well as add a light green background to the logo to stand out. That's it, folks. The design is finished. I will tweak the elements a little more to give it the final touches, and it is ready to be used for final destinations. I will export it and save a final copy in my projects folder. Thank you for watching our video to the end. I hope you have learned new skills and can use it for your future projects. Comment below your opinions and let us know what you think. Until next time, be happy and practice your skills.